fearlessness, trust. We as human beings, we know, we can rationalize it, that there is actually no one to be feared. We are all equals. And as human beings, with superior intelligence, we are not even afraid of animals, wild animals, or ghosts, or beasts. However, I think in reality, this fearlessness, fear, as you have defined in the earlier session, was again one of the fear was an inhuman act of another human being. Well, we think we are fearless, we trust. However, but then again, this fear might also come from preconditioning, and it may be interpreted. If you act like fearless, it may be misinterpreted as being lack of respect in certain social contexts. And also, this fearlessness doesn't actually mean like you're as strong as any mightiest person in the world, or you know everything. But in reality, this that kind of anxiety or uneasiness or whatsoever in the daily walk of our life, social interaction, it's quite difficult to practice this fearlessness. Maybe you are fearless, but then other might interpret you as lack of respect or understanding, thereby endanger your, in reality, immunity. It may be quite difficult. So some kind of clarity on that.
There are two issues. One has to do with the body, and the other has to do with the self. So this fearlessness, at the level of self, which you are talking about, this issue of respect and things like that. Of course, this is what is required to ensure this big requirement of living with justice. From family to world family. This is what is required to ensure fearlessness, to ensure trust. So this is a big way to go. But we as human beings, we all want to be fearless. So this fearlessness is a natural acceptance for all of us. But in order to give rise to this fearlessness, this is the distance we have to cover. And now you can see that for human being, just physical facility is not important. Physical facility is also important. But then for you, issues like this are important. Fearlessness is something which is important for you. And as you said, one keeps worrying in one way or the other. It keeps hanging in your mind. If you have any trace of fear from anyone, whether human being or rest of nature, that is, what is the meaning of, when we said, living in relationship with human beings? This is a basic need. And as long as it is not fulfilled for human beings, it keeps troubling you. So if you have any trace of fear from any human being, or any unit belonging to the rest of nature, the animals, or the water, or the rain, or anything. So any trace of this fear keeps troubling us. We try to undermine it and forget about it and do and things. But if you really start looking into yourself, you will see it keeps troubling. So this is so important for you, for human beings. And then, therefore, you want to ensure fearlessness. You want to ensure trust with everyone. starting from family to one family. Right? You can see, you know, it might sound very big, you know, when we wrote this the first time. But as you go on, you know, investigating into it, in terms of your need for fearlessness, your need for trust, your need for being in relationship with everyone. Okay. This is a very common need for all of us. So, this, you know, living with justice with everyone, starting from family to one family, or living in an undivided society, then only there will be no place of fear as long as human being is concerned. The rest of nature is still, you know, has to be talked about, that will come here. So this is ensuring that I can be free from fear of any human being if this happens. Then I can be free from human being and rest of nature, you know, from fear of human being and rest of nature if this is ensured. This is what we are going to call as universal human order. So this takes care of both human beings as well as the rest of them. These are essential for all of us. And they are the common needs. And as long as it is not fulfilled, right, we keep getting troubled about it. We keep feeling uncomfortable about it. Just having physical safety does not ensure continuity of happiness for us. So when we said for animals this is necessary and complete, right? For human beings it is necessary but not complete. For us the issue of relationship is so important. Relationship with human beings and relationship with the rest of nature. Because any problem there results into fear. And this is not what we, you know, exactly desire for. And if you really start looking into yourself very, you know, sharply, as I said, every moment, then you can see any trace of fear. Right? Makes you mad. Any trace of distrust, makes you mad. You are not comfortable with it. And you want to get to that. And you can also see that the way we have designed the whole civilization today, right, we are all the time under fear. Because if you start with this belief that there is struggle for survival and there is survival of the fittest, this is what we are teaching in the name of education, then are we making our students fearless or full of fear? So what is happening? You are now afraid of everybody. He might not even know you, but you are afraid of him. Then you make things like, you know, becoming richest man on the earth. Now just imagine what you have done. You have created 700 crore people. Right? Against you. Living in fear or fearlessness? So all these kind of ambitions which we keep creating, you know, in the name of education today, or promoted by society, what it is doing is making our life miserable, unhappy. And it is also making the life of other people unhappy. If you think that there is a struggle for survival and there is survival which is there, then everybody is against you. So you are fear from everyone or you are fearless? Fear from everyone. So all these, you know, issues you can slowly start investigating. What we have done in the last 5 years is prepare the base for you to be able to see all the things. first, at least start paying attention to yourself and see that what is of concern for you is your happiness, the continuity of happiness in the self. And that is what you are working for. So first you become aware of that. Then you start thinking to yourself, right, with all fineness. Then you start looking into your relationship with the human being. Then you will look into the relationship with the rest of nature. So you slowly become sensitive to all these things. Then you can clearly see what is your state of being, what is it that is natural for you, desirable for you, what is it which is not natural, which is not desirable. Right? If you do all this, then you will realize what we are doing in the name of civilization today, in the name of modernity, in the name of modern, you know, civilization, modern culture and so on. Right? Are we trying to do something which is in accordance with you? Human natural acceptance of human being? Or is it against this human consciousness? So instead of creating solutions, we are creating problems. Large number of problems. So we have, you know, given this belief to the student that there is struggle for survival, there is a survival difficulty, and therefore you have to compete with everyone. What do you think? We have created a solution or a problem?